Good morning, dear students. Today we will continue chapter 14, Chemical Effects of Electric Current. In the previous video, part 1 video, we studied about some important concepts and some important terms related to electric current. We studied that there are some liquids which are good conductors of electricity, like tap water, salty water, lemon juice, etc. And there are some liquids which are poor conductors of electricity, like distilled water, which is a pure form of water, alcohol, oil. These are the some liquids which do not conduct electricity. They are poor conductors of electricity. Today in this video, we will study the chemical effects of the electric current. That means when electric current is passed through a conducting liquid, it causes some kind of chemical changes in that. This phenomena is known as the chemical effects of electric current. When electric current, as I told you, when electric current passes through any conducting liquid, it causes some kind of chemical changes. How we will get to know that any kind of chemical changes have taken place? Okay, so it will be visible to us either in form of the bubbles of the gas will be visible at the electrodes. Okay, or there will be some deposition of the metal on any of the electrode. Okay, on any of the electrode, it will be visible in form of deposition. Okay, or there may be change in the color of the solution. So like this, it will be we will get to know that any kind of chemical changes have taken place. So before understanding these chemical effects of electric current in detail, let us understand some important terms. First is electrolysis. Electrolysis means process of chemical decomposition of electrolyte on passing electric current. That means on passing electric current through the electrolyte, it dissociates. Okay, decomposes. What are the electrolytes? Electrolyte means any liquid or the solution when electric current is passed through the electrolyte means through any liquid or the solution, it dissociates into ions and conduct electricity. Okay, so electrolysis means the process of chemical decomposition of electrolyte on passing electric current. Okay, so the electrolyte, when the electric current is passed through the electrolytes, they conduct electricity. Next is electrodes. What are the electrodes? Here you can see in this beaker, copper sulfate solution has been taken. Okay, and these are the two electrodes. What are the electrodes? Electrodes are, these are the conducting rods. Okay, these are the conducting rods which connects the solution to the external circuit. Here you can see, here I have, this is anode, this is cathode. The electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, that is known as the anode. And the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, that is known as cathode. Okay, an electric current, it always flows from positive terminal of the battery to the negative terminal. So there is, in other words, you can also define anode as, it is the electrode through which the current enters the solution. Okay, through which the current enters the solution. And cathode is the electrode through which the current leaves the solution. Okay, through which the current leave the solution. I hope now electrodes are clear. So this phenomena of chemical effects of electric current, it is very useful. Okay, like the process electroplating, it has many. It is very useful for us. For example, it is used for electroplating purpose or for refining the metals like silver, gold, etc. Now we will study electroplating in detail. Electroplating, this is the process in which a desired metal, it is deposited on any another material by means of electricity. Okay, here you can see the name electroplating. So here, the deposition of any desired metal on any other material is done with the help of the electricity. Let's talk about the advantages of the electroplating. Electroplating, it is used for the decorative purpose. For example, the jewelry makers, they make the jewelry with the, for example, jewelry makers, they make artificial jewelry. They make the jewelry with less expensive metal, and then coating of the gold or silver is done on that less expensive metal so as to make that more decorative. Okay, and the electroplating, it is also done for, it is also used for the corrosion prevention. For example, iron, we know that gets corroded. Okay, so the on the iron, a coating of zinc is done so as to prevent it from the corrosion. Tin cans, they are used for storing food. So on the cans of the iron, coating of tin is done. Okay, so that the food stored in the tin cans, it will not come in contact with the iron and it will not get spoiled. Okay, so these were the some advantages of the electroplating. Now let's understand this process of electroplating in detail. So now, for example, there is one steel spoon. Okay, there is one steel spoon. For example, there is one steel spoon on which we want to do the electroplating. This is steel spoon and this is copper plate. For example, on this steel spoon, we want to do the coating of copper. Okay. Before doing the electroplating, we need to understand some things. As I told you, this is the steel spoon on which we want to do the coating of copper. Okay, so the thing on which we want to do the coating, that should be connected to the negative terminal. That means that should be made cathode. And the coating of which material we want to do. For example, here we want to do the coating of copper. So that copper plate will be connected to the positive terminal. So here, after making these connections, now leave this and the because we want to do the coating of copper, so we will take the solution of copper sulfate. Okay. After that, after 25 to 30 minutes, you will observe that you will observe a reddish coating on the this steel spoon. Okay. Now we need to understand that how this process it happened, how it took place. Okay, how the copper it got coated on the steel spoon. Let us try to understand it with the help of these equations. So what will happen when electricity will pass through this? So the copper sulfate solution, it will dissociate into copper ions and sulfate ions. Okay. So what I told you that when current is passed through, in case of the electrolyte, I had told you that when electric current is passed through the electrolyte, it dissociates into the ions and conduct electricity. When electric current will be passed through the solution, it will dissociate into copper ions and sulfate ions. There will be many copper ions and sulfate ions on passing electric current through the copper sulfate solution. These copper ions, they are, you can see the copper has positive charge. It will get attracted to this cathode and the copper will get deposited on the steel spoon. Okay, so all the copper ions from the solution, they will start depositing on the steel spoon. We need to restore the copper ions in the solution. So how it will be done? So the copper from the copper plate, here you can see, now coming to the reaction here taking place at the anode. So copper from the copper plate, it will lose two electrons and form the copper ions. Okay, so the copper from this copper plate, it will come into the solution in form of copper ions. Okay, it will come into the solution in form of the copper ions. And the two electrons, they will be transferred to the cathode. I told you now, the copper from the copper plate, it will lose two electrons and form the copper ions. And these two electrons, because they are negatively charged, so they will be transferred from here, they will be transferred to the cathode. Okay, so here the copper, I told you that copper ions, they are positively charged, so they will be attracted to this cathode. And here, on absorbing the electrons, the copper will be deposited on this steel spoon. Okay. And the copper from this copper plate, it is restoring the amount of the copper ions in the solution. So like this, the copper will be deposited on the steel spoon. This electroplating process, it is very useful for us. As I told you earlier also, it is used for the decoration purpose, it is used for the corrosion prevention, etc. So there is one more activity has been given in the book. On page number B60. Activity 14.6. Here you can see to study the chemical effects of current on the copper sulfate. Okay, this is same This is same as this activity which I have just explained. What is the difference? Here we have taken the steel spoon, okay, and here both the plates are of copper. So what will happen? Copper from this positive plate, it will start getting deposited on this negative plate. One more activity has been given in the book on page number B59 to study the chemical effect of electric current on water. So what happens when electric current is passed through the water? So you can see here in your book, here this arrangement has been made. What has been done? Take some water in a beaker, okay? Add few drops of the sulfuric acid in this so as to make this water more conductive. You can see here these two white, you can see these are the electrodes which have been connected to the battery. Now take two test tubes. These are the two test tubes you can see here. Fill them with the water. Take two test tubes, fill them with the water. Now keep thumb on the open end of the mouth. Now invert them and put here on the electrodes. Okay, here you can see some spacing, but when these test tubes were kept on the electrodes, these were completely filled with the water. Okay, now after doing all these arrangements, we keep this all arrangement undisturbed for about half an hour. After some time, you will notice that you will see some bubbles of gases here. You will see some bubbles of the gases here at the electrodes. What are these? Okay, so what happens when electric current is passed through the water? So the water breaks up into its elements, hydrogen and oxygen. Here in the test tube A, you can see here, this is the oxygen gas has collected here, and in the test tube B, you can see in test tube A, oxygen gas has collected, and in test tube B, hydrogen gas has collected. You can see here in the test tube B, the volume of the gas in the test tube B is double than the test tube A. How you can say this? Because here the gas has displaced more water as compared to the test tube A. Okay, so in the test tube A, the gas collected is oxygen, and the test tube B, the gas collected is hydrogen. And the amount of the gas collected in the hydrogen is doubled as compared to the oxygen that has got collected in the test tube A. So this was all about the chemical effects of the electric current. Here chapter 14 is complete. Thank you.